Hi everybody, welcome back. We have learned what is auxiliary verbs and its first kind primary auxiliaries earlier. Be forms, have forms and do forms helps merely to express statement of facts. We will learn the second kind of auxiliary verbs today, modal auxiliaries. Modal auxiliaries help us to express conceptions of mind such as possibilities, probabilities, obligations, wishes, exceptions, etc. I will help you to recollect modal auxiliaries listed. Will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might, must, ought, need, dare, used to are the modal auxiliaries. Remember, modal auxiliaries denote future, which means to express future present and future past. We have a simple classification of modal auxiliary verbs in English. First one, true modal auxiliaries. And second one, semi-modal auxiliaries. And also we have present and past future forms. Of each, we will learn what are the present true modals and past true modals. Look at the table given. Present true modals. Will, shall, can, may, must is called present true modal auxiliaries. Past true modals, would, should, could, might are called past true modals. Remember, will, shall, can, may, must are used to express future present form. On the other hand, would, should, could, might are used to express future past form. The second classification of modal auxiliary is semi-modal auxiliaries. Semi-modal auxiliaries are divided into two: the present semi-modal and the past semi-modal. We will learn what are the present semi-modal auxiliaries and the past semi-modal auxiliaries. Look at the table. Present semi-modal auxiliaries. Ought, need, dare. We have only one past semi-modal auxiliary, that is used to. When we discuss future present and future past modals, you have to remember the following points. Not one, there is no past forms for must and ought. Their past actions are expressed by the usage had and did respectively. Not two, need and dare are used as the main verbs. Not three, used is already in the past form and also used as an ordinary verb. Remember, the basic knowledge of these points helps you to use modal auxiliaries in its true meaning. Let us learn the uses of modal auxiliaries, true modal auxiliaries and semi-modal auxiliaries. The use of true modal auxiliary will: future action, future prediction, promise, willingness, warning, request, a decision taken now. We will write one example of each. He will leave on Sunday. Here, the true modal auxiliary will denote a future action. The price will go up. Here, the true modal auxiliary will denote future prediction. I will help you. Here, the true modal auxiliary denote a promise. We will come to tea with you. Here, the true modal auxiliary will denote willingness. I will beat you if you trouble me. Here, the true modal auxiliary will denote a warning. Will you please open the door? Here, the true modal auxiliary will denote request. I think I will take an auto. Here, the true modal auxiliary denote a decision taken now. The use of true modal auxiliary shall. Future action, offering help, order, warning, promise. We will write one example of each. I shall visit you. Here, the true modal auxiliary shall denote a future action. Shall we go for a film? Here, the true modal auxiliary shall offering a help. You shall obey me. Here, the true modal auxiliary shall denote an order. He shall be punished if he comes late. Here, the true modal auxiliary shall denote a warning. You shall have a holiday tomorrow. Here, the true modal auxiliary denote a promise. The use of true modal auxiliary can. Ability, permission, request, offering, help. We will write examples of each. I can swim. Here, the true modal auxiliary can denote an ability. Can I leave early? Here, the true modal auxiliary can denote a permission. Can you give me your pen? Here, the true modal auxiliary can denote a request. Can I help you? Here, the true modal auxiliary can denote offering a help. The use of modal auxiliary may. To express a possibility in future. To talk about actions in the future. We will write an example of each. He may be in the computer room. Here, the true modal auxiliary may denote to express a possibility in future. I may go to Hyderabad. Here, the true modal auxiliary may denote to talk about actions in the future. The use of true modal auxiliary must. To express necessity to do something. We will write one example. You must work hard. Here, the true modal auxiliary must denote to express necessity to do something. Remember, will, shall, can, may is used to express future present. The use of true modal auxiliary would. To express a wish, to make a request, to express a possibility in the past. we will write examples of each. I would like to see this book. Here, the true modal auxiliary would denote to express a wish. Would you mind posting this letter? Here, the true modal auxiliary would denote to make a request. I would have helped you if you had asked me. Here, the true modal auxiliary would denote to express a possibility in the past. The use of true modal auxiliary should: to express duty, to give advice or opinion, when something is expected to happen, to express the right thing. We will write examples of each. We should help the poor. Here, the true modal auxiliary should denote to express duty. I think you should take care of your health. Here, the true modal auxiliary should denote to give advice or opinion. She should pass the exam. Here, the true modal auxiliary should denote when something is expected to happen. You should have worked hard. Here, the true modal auxiliary should denote to express the right thing. The use of true modal auxiliary could: request permission, to express a wish. We will write examples of each. Could you open the door, please? Here, the true modal auxiliary could denote a request. Could I use your telephone, please? Here, the true modal auxiliary could denote a permission. I wish I could fly like a bird. Here, the true modal auxiliary could denote to express a wish. The use of true modal auxiliary might: for a possibility in the past, to talk about actions in the future. We will write examples of each. You might have left it in the class. Here, the true modal auxiliary might denote for a possibility in the past. I might go to Delhi. Here, the true modal auxiliary might denote to talk about actions in the future. Remember, would, should, could, might is used to express future past. Let us learn the use of semi-modal auxiliaries. The use of semi-modal auxiliary ought: to express a duty. We will write one example. You ought to work hard. Here, the semi-modal auxiliary ought denote to express a duty. The use of semi-modal auxiliary need: to express something required. We will write one example. You need work harder. Here, the semi-modal auxiliary need denote to express something required. The use of semi-modal auxiliary dare: as a warning. We will write one example. How dare you speak like that? Here, the semi-modal auxiliary dare denote as a warning. Remember, ought, need, dare is used to express future present. The use of semi-modal auxiliary used to: a habit in the past. We will write one example. We used to live in a small house. Here, the semi-modal auxiliary used to denote a habit in the past. Remember, used to is used to express future past form. Today's session we will wind up. We will be back with our next video, Kinds of Sentence. Please subscribe and don't forget to press bell icon. Have a good day until we come back.